Alright, so sa mga gising pa dyan, welcome to our lecture. Apologies for the late start of this lecture kasi my computer broke down. So, buti na lang meron pang isang spare dito. Kinahoy ko yung parts and then yun, tagpi-tagpi. And then nakabuo rin ng working computer. Anyway, at least okay na. And we are now able to have our lectures this morning. Okay? In a few hours, magkakaroon na kayo ng exam sa ibang subject. So, good luck and God bless sa exams ninyo. Juniors, okay? Mga third year. BS Accountancy and BS Management Accounting students. So before we formally start yung lecture natin for this morning, let us pray the Lewisian prayer. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O God, wellspring of goodness and blessings, we give you thanks and praise as one Lewisian community. The graces you incessantly grant upon us and your divine providence have sustained our beloved university throughout the years of mission and excellence. Having been founded by the Congregation of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, we pray that you keep us committed and dedicated to our mission and identity, to serve the Church and the society as we become living witnesses to the gospel values proclaimed by Jesus. For if we are steadfast in our good and beautiful mission, our works will bring success not only to ourselves, but also to those whom we are bound to love and serve. Inspired by St. Louis, our patron saint, who was filled with a noble spirit that steered him to love you above all things, may we also live believing that we are born for a greater purpose and mission as we dwell in your presence all the days of our life. Grant all these supplications through the intercession of Mother Mary and through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So again, good morning to everyone. And for this morning, for this session, we shall be talking about the Data Privacy Act or Republic Act number 10173. Okay? So, the Data Privacy Act is not actually a law that prohibits the sharing of information, okay? It does not actually prohibit. Yun nga, the more accurate purpose of this law would be to enable the responsible sharing of information. Okay, yun lang. Pinopromote lang nitong law na ito yung responsableng paggamit ng information. Okay, ng data. Okay? And yun nga. The declaration of policy, okay? It is the policy of the state to protect the fundamental right of privacy of communication while ensuring free flow of information to promote innovation and growth. The state recognizes the vital role of information and communications technology in nation building. Kasi nga, in our times ngayon, okay, very vital talaga yung information and communications technology in nation building. Okay, although in the ancient times, information is also circulating. Yun nga lang, more so ngayon, okay, wherein mabilisan na lahat. Okay, so information and communications technology is vital in nation building and the state recognizes that. Okay, and because of that, it is the duty of the state, okay, to ensure that the personal information in systems, okay, in filing systems, in information systems, okay, in the government and in the private sector are secured and protected. So the state accords some kind of protection, okay, for sensitive information and for personal information. Okay, now definition of terms. Commission shall refer to the NPC, okay, created by virtue of this act. Okay, this is different from the constitutional commissions na alam natin. You have learned this maybe in your constitution subject. Nagkaroon ba kayo ng ganon? Sa amin kasi nung college kami meron eh. I'm not Sure. Or baka na-take up na niya sa senior high. So doon, di ba, meron tayong Civil Service Commission, the Commission on Elections, and the Commission on Audit. Okay, pero ito, this is also another commission. Yun nga lang, it's not created by virtue of the Constitution, but by virtue of this Act, RA 10173. Okay, yung definition of terms pala natin dito naka-alphabetize, no? Okay, so proceed tayo sa next. Consent of the data subject. Dapat inuna muna yung data subject, di ba? Consent of the data subject. Sino ba yung data subject, di ba? Anyway, yun nga, naka-alphabetize kasi ito. So, unahin na muna natin yung data subject. So, the data subject refers to an individual whose personal information is processed. Okay, kasi yung personal information naman na yan, in certain important offices, agencies, banks, and other institutions, they will use your information to process something. Okay, like for example, in a bank, okay, for you to be able to use the services of a bank, kailangan makuha mo na yung information ninyo. Okay, and then after each transaction, this information will be used or will be collected by bank personnel to confirm that it is really you who are, it's really the account holder or the depositor na nakikipag-transact dun sa bank. Okay, for security purposes. Okay, now, if you are the owner of that personal information to be processed, then you are called for purposes of this law, the data subject. Okay, now, next, consent of the data subject refers to any freely given, specific, informed indication of will. Okay, so from the word itself, consent of the data subject, syempre, if information about this person is going to be used, then the data subject must be able to freely give his consent muna, okay, before such information can be processed or used. Okay, and how do we know that there is consent? Kailangan he agrees, okay, the data subject must agree to the collection and the processing of personal information. Okay, and how do we know that he agrees? Number one, if the consent is freely given, eto, okay, specific, and it's an informed indication of will. Even if it is freely given, even if it is specific, kung hindi naman niya sinabi, okay, if it's not informed, oh, di ba? So, informed indication of will is also important, okay? And the consent shall be evidenced by written, electronic, or recorded means. Okay, how will consent be manifested? Okay, in written, electronic, or recorded means. By means of signature. Okay, if a person's signature appears in a document, parang he gives consent, okay, on the information that is placed on that document, or he ascertains that the information in that document is true and correct. Okay? So, yun, signature. Very important yung signature. Kaya nga, meron din, meron kasing forgery eh, di ba? So, kailangan may protections din about forgery. Pero that's beside the topic, no? Basta, if there's signature, there's consent. Okay? Whether that signature is forged or not is another topic. Okay? So, opt-in box or clicking an icon, that also means consent. Kasi, for example, mag-upload kayo sa Facebook ng pictures ninyo. Or mag-story kayo, or mag-my day, ganyan. Pag pinindot ninyo yung button na, anong button na kasi yan? I'm not sure, hindi rin kasi ako masyadong nag-my day, eh, di ba? So, basta may button dun sa bottom right, I guess. And then, if you click that, then it means you are giving consent that that image that you own is to be uploaded and to be shown to the public, or kung kanino nyo man sinet yung privacy settings ninyo, if it's for friends only, friends except, or specific person, or only me. Nag-story ka pa kung only me, di ba? Okay? So, yun. Okay, you're giving consent by clicking an icon. Okay, another, sending a confirmation email. Kung hiningan ka ng information and you sent an email as a reply to that request, and in that reply, you are confirming your the giving of your consent, edi yun din. That's also consent. Eh, or pwede rin namang oral confirmation as long as it is recorded. Okay? So written, signature, electronic, yung opt-in box or yung clicking an icon or sending a confirmation email, and recorded means yung oral confirmation ninyo. Sometimes there are banks who will call you, okay, and then ask if you confirm, and then you just reply yes, mga ganyan, di ba? So if may pre-record siya ng boses mo na ask na yun na, siguro may pre-record yung bank ng boses mo na nagsasabing yes, okay, and then yun. Pag narinig nung system yung yes mo at tumugma dun sa naka-store sa kanila, di i-go na niya yung transaction. That is why nga, di ba, merong mga fraudsters na ang ginagawa ganon, di ba? So, tatawagan ka and then sasabihin may problema yung ano nyo, yung account niyo or something, and then sabihin mo daw yes, ganon, no? Mga ganon. Okay, then, pag ganon, ayun. So, recorded means siya. It's still a means of giving consent. Okay? Pero recorded means. Basta written, economic, or recorded means. Okay? Yun nga. Kasi kailangan nagkaroon ng evidence. Okay? That you are actually giving consent. Okay? It may also be given on behalf of the data subject by an agent. Okay? Specifically authorized by the data subject to do so. So, kahit hindi mismo yung data subject, basta meron siyang agent who represents yung data subject, and that agent on behalf of the data subject gives the consent, then ganun na rin. Okay? Consent of the agent is also consent of the principal as long as it is within his authority. Okay? Next, direct marketing refers to communication by whatever means of any advertising or marketing material which is directed to particular individuals. Okay, syempre, may target market itong mga establishments na ito, lalo na yung mga direct selling, di ba? So, communication may be in the form of a letter, mga ganyan, okay? Syempre, how will they know your address, your names? You must be properly addressed in that marketing letter, okay? So, yun. Okay, that's direct marketing. Next, filing system. It can be manual or it can be electronic. So although the information is not processed by equipment operating automatically, so manual. Okay, so pwedeng manual, pwedeng electronic, as long as in such a way that specific information relating to a particular person is readily accessible. Okay, so may sistema, okay, and then if certain information is needed, then a personnel of that organization who holds or who has custody over your over sensitive information or personal information, then yun, okay, pupunta lang siya sa filing system kasi nakaayos na yun, so readily accessible na yung mga information doon. Next, information and communication system refers to a system of generating, sending, receiving, storing, or otherwise processing electronic data messages or electronic documents. Okay? Financial statements, okay? Accounting systems, pwede. Okay? Kasi information system din naman yan. Accounting information system, okay? And paglalagyan mo ng communications, then, yun nga, in the form of correspondences, letters, okay, and yun nga, in that letter, syempre, may personal information, like the addressee, his address, mga ganyan. Okay, and of course, the contents of the letter, okay, that's also information, okay? Next, personal information refers to any information, whether recorded or in a material form or not, from which the identity of an individual is apparent. Okay, dun muna tayo, no? So, apparent. Parang, if a certain information points to a certain person, okay, or it can be reasonably and directly ascertained by the entity holding the information, then that is personal information. Basta apparent yung identity ng isang tao. For example, the complete name of a person, okay, first name, middle name, last name. Okay, pag kompleto yan, chances are it will point to a certain person. Okay, kasi malay natin, unique yung name. Okay, pero although marami naman magkakapangalan, di ba? Okay? So, kung may magkakapangalan, maybe we will add more information so that mas maging apparent yung identity ng isang tao. But if the individual's identity is not apparent, then that is not personal information. Like, for example, first name lang. Okay? Patrick lang, for example. Okay? So, ang dami eh. How do you know that a certain individual is being identified? Okay? Eh, first name lang naman. So, that's not personal information. Pero kapag dinugtungan ninyo ng buong pangalan ko, I will not disclose my name. Although, nakakalagay pala dito. Dun sa baba. Okay? Below my picture. Anyway, yun. Patrick Louis Reyes. O, di yun. Okay? Baka meron ding ibang Patrick Louis, di ba? Reyes, di ba? Malay natin meron. Okay? Pero baka engineer, baka doktor. Eto nakalagay, oh. Kama CPA, oh. Baka ako yon, di ba? So, yon. Okay? So, it becomes personal information only if the identity of a certain individual is, you know, apparent. Nagiging obvious na. Okay? So, ganon. Or when put together with other information would directly and certainly identify an individual. So, ganon nga. Kung may magkakapangalan, let's say, for example, Patrick Reyes. Patrick's a very common name. Reyes is a very common surname din. So, pag pinagsama mo, very common talaga. Now, if... Try ko nga minsan siguro i-search, no, Patrick Reyes sa Facebook. Tingnan natin, tas ilagay ko sa GC lahat, no. Anyway, so pag dinugtungan mo ng, for example, birthday, okay? Marami nang maaalis diyan. Okay? Or baka ako lang yung Patrick Reyes na ganun yung birthday. Birth date pala para mas ano, mas ano? Para mas specific. Okay? May year of birth. Okay? Or, let's say, address and birthday. Okay? Those are two information. So, pag pinagsama mo, let's say, you know the address. Okay? Pwede mo nang puntahan and then you ask inside, sino ba yung may ganitong birthday? Okay? Nga lang, kung, for example, pupunta kayo sa bahay nila Charmaine at Charlotte, o alam nyo yung address, okay, tapos papasok kayo dun sa loob ng bahay, sino po yung may birthday na ganito? Eh, baka parehas sila ng birthday, diba? Si Charlotte tsaka si Charmaine. Okay? Hindi pa rin apparent kung sino yung ina-identify na individual. Pero kung dugtungan mo pa ng other information, ah, boyfriend ni Richard, ah, okay, si Charlotte yon. Okay? Diba? Mga ganon. Okay, so pag ganon, very apparent na, or... No, apparent na yung identity ng individual, then that's personal information. If it is not complete, if it does not point towards a certain individual, then that's not personal information. And not covered, therefore, by the Data Privacy Act. Okay, next. Personal information controller. Okay, refers to a person or organization who controls the collection, holding, processing, or use of personal information. Okay, so... including a person or organization who instructs another person or organization to collect, hold, process, use, transfer, or disclose personal information on his or her behalf. The term excludes, number one, a person or organization who performs such functions as instructed by another person or organization. Kasi if you are performing such functions as instructed by another, then you are a personal information processor. Okay, which we will be defining later. Okay? Or number two, an individual who collects, holds, processes, or uses personal information in connection with personal, family, or household affairs. Then that's not covered. Okay, hindi siya personal. That individual is not referred to as a personal information controller or PIC. Okay, then next naman yung PIP. Okay, refers to any natural or juridical person qualified to act, to whom a personal information controller may outsource the processing of personal data pertaining to a data subject. Okay, for example, USL and BPI. Okay, USL and BPI, they are, you know, partners. They have an engagement. Okay, USL, for example, submits a list of the employees and their corresponding bank account, a BPI bank, sorry, BPI account numbers, okay, and yung kanilang salary to be credited for that cut-off, for that period, for that two-week period. O, yun. Yung mga information na yan, isasubmit sa BPI, okay, so USL outsources the processing of information to BPI. BPI now does the processing. Okay, para ma-credit na sa kanilang amounts. Okay, so para makasahod na. Okay, so in that scenario, USL is the PIC, okay? They control the collection, holding, processing, or use of personal information. Kasi once an employee applies for a position inside USL, kino-collect yung information yan. Okay, and then they hold that information. And then they use that personal information. Now, sila, USL is the PIC in that case, no? And then, yung PIP, that would be BPI. Kasi, the PIC outsources to BPI the processing of that personal data. Binigay lang personal data. Binigay lang ng USL sa BPI. Okay, BPI, ikaw na bahala. Okay. O, BPI will now credit yung mga amounts na nandun, okay, to the respective bank account numbers. Okay, so kasi BPI is the one who does the processing. Sino bang nag-demand or sino yung nag-outsource? It's the PIC, USL. Okay, so ganun lang yun. Processing refers to any information or any set of operations performed upon personal information, okay, including but not limited to collection, recording, organization, storage, updating, retrieval, consultation, use, consolidation, blocking, erasure, or destruction of data. Okay, that's processing. Okay, privileged information refers to any and all forms of data under which under the rules of court and other pertinent laws constitute privileged communication. So, yun nga, from the term itself, no, privileged information. And pag sinabi mong privileged information, it's information that you get to see by virtue of your privilege. Okay, like for example, you are a lawyer, okay, and you have a client. Syempre, the client will have to provide certain information about the circumstances leading to the, circumstances surrounding the case, okay, dun sa kanyang abogado. And the lawyer, syempre, has access to that information kasi nga, sinabi sa kanya firsthand by the client. Now, there is an attorney-client relationship between those two individuals. Okay? So, by virtue of the privilege of the lawyer being the counsel of that client, edi meron siyang privileged information. I mean, the information shared between the two of them is privileged information. And the lawyer has the duty to protect that privileged information. He cannot disclose that information unless it is used for its purpose. Like for example, sa korte, he makes his arguments. Okay? And syempre, he will be divulging information about the client. Okay? And what happened during the case. Mga ganon. Okay, yun. So, if it is used for that purpose, then it's okay. Pero kung ginamit niya yung information, pinag-chismisa niya sa iba or what, or any other purpose, then that is not allowed. Okay? So, meron din tayong physician-patient relationship. So, kasi medical information is also sensitive information eh. Okay? We will be going to that later. Okay. So yun. Okay, so the physician is under the has a duty, okay, to protect, okay, the privileged information that he has access to. Okay, hindi naman pwedeng, if for example, he owns a clinic and meron siyang storage ng mga information about results of medical tests, ganyan, and other information, syempre pangalan, age, the gender, and others. Okay, and then a certain person will come to that clinic, sasabihin niya, oy doc, paano naman, patingin nga yung information ni ganito, ganyan. Okay, that's not allowed. The physician must not do that. Okay, meron ding ano, relationship between the a minister or priest and a person making confession. Kasi a person who, you know, for example, in the Catholic Church, di ba, meron tayong seven sacraments, one of which is the sacrament of reconciliation, di ba? So, in that sacrament, a person asks forgiveness from Christ's representatives, which are the priests, no? If the priest absolves or forgives the sins of this person making confession, then he's also forgive sa taas. Okay? Ayun. So, yun. The priest, parang wala pa naman ako naririnig na priest na nag-divulge, no, ng information. Ay, alam mo, sinabi, nagkumpisal sa akin yung si ganito. Siya daw pala yung pumatay kay ganito, ganyan. Okay? Well, such information, yung mga ganyan, may be subpoenaed by the courts. Lalo na kung pag pinatay, pinatay, di ba? Siyempre, murder case yan. So, pwede. Pwede ipasubpoena yan. Pero, that's an exception. Pag general rule, okay, privileged information must not be divulged. Okay? Hindi dapat i-disclose sa kung kani-kanino. Okay? Ayun. So, that's ito pa, public officers given information in official confidence. Okay? Yun, public officers, meaning civil servants, okay? If you are given information and sabi confidential, di, you have a duty not to disclose. Okay? Next, sensitive personal information refers to personal information about individual's race, ethnic origin, marital status, age, color, and religious, philosophical, or political affiliations. Okay? About an individual's health, education, genetic, or sexual life of a person, or to any proceeding for any offense committed or alleged to have been committed by such person, the disposal of such proceedings or the sentence of any court in such proceedings. Okay, yung health, educational background, okay, genetic or sexual life, ganyan. Pati pala mga ano, uy, alam mo ba yan, kapitbahay natin eh, may kaso pala yan sa ano. Mga ganyan, ay, hindi rin pwede. Okay, hindi rin, sensitive information din yan. Okay, issued by government agencies peculiar to an individual, which includes but not limited to SSS numbers, previous or current health records, licenses or its denials, suspension or revocation, and tax returns. Okay? SSS number, TIN, what else? PhilHealth number, mga ganyan. Hindi dapat, ano, dinidisclose. Okay? Kasi pwedeng magamit sa masama. Okay? And lastly, specifically established by an executive order or an act of Congress to be kept classified. Okay? Scope, okay? This law is applicable to the processing of all types of personal information. Okay? And to, syempre, kinocover niya yung processing, and of course, it covers also individual person. Okay? does not apply to the following. Okay, ito yung mga exceptions. Dito sila hindi applicable. The Data Privacy Act does not apply to the following. Number one, information about any individual who is or was an officer or employee of a government institution that relates to the position or functions of the individual, including the fact that the individual is or was an officer or employee of the government institution, the title, business address, and office telephone number of the individual. Okay? Sige, let's try. I think, sige, sa BIR tayo. Aha. BIR. Ayan, directory. Ayan. Regional offices. Let's say dito. Okay? So, yan. Information about an individual who is or was an officer or employee of a government institution. Okay, letter B. The title, business address, and office telephone number of the individual. Okay? Ayan, may pangalan siya. Let's say the regional director. Okay? May pangalan, may office address, may email pa nga eh. Okay? And the office telephone number. Okay? So, yun. Can the regional director of RR3, Tuguegarao City, claim na na-violate yung kanyang privacy rights? Bakit dinisplay sa website namin yung pangalan ko, pati yung address ng kung saan ako nagtatrabaho, tapos pati yung office telephone number ko, baka tanta rin ako ng mga prank calls? Okay, sasabihin ganun. No. The Data Privacy Act will not apply. Okay? To that. Okay? Okay, hindi yan mag-apply. Okay? Classification, salary range, and responsibilities of the person held by the individual, name of the individual on a document prepared by the individual in the course of employment within the government. Okay? Ito, itong letter C, I think only kapag, ano, kasi sobrang sensitive ditong, range naman pala, kaya okay lang. Okay, hindi pala yung exact na salary. Okay? And then, ayun, in documents kasi, documents in the government warrant accountability, and therefore, the name of the individual who prepared such document, nilalagay niya yung pangalan niya doon. Okay, and dahil nilalagay niya yung pangalan niya doon, o di, or nilalagay yung pangalan niya doon, okay, not necessarily himself ang naglagay, okay, so he cannot invoke the Data Privacy Act's protection. Okay, kasi nga, it was prepared, your name was, or and any other personal information is placed there in that document, okay, in the course of your job, okay, with the government, okay. Next, information about an individual who is or was performing service under contract. Information relating to any discretionary benefit of a financial nature. Personal information process for journalistic, artistic, literary, or research. Okay, information necessary to in order to carry out the functions of public authority. Information necessary for banks and other financial institutions. O, di ba sa mga banko? If you create an account, kukunin ang pangalan mo, they'll get your signature, they'll get your ID picture number, and other information. Ang tagal-tagal mo mag-fill out yan kasi napakaraming information ang hinihingi. Okay? So, ayun. Dahil necessary for banks, then you have to, hindi yan mako-cover na Data Privacy Act. Okay? And then, lalo na kapag hiningi ng AMLA yung personal information mo, pwede nilang makuha yun. Okay? And then, personal information originally collected from residents of foreign jurisdictions. Okay? Protection afforded to journalists and their sources. May protection to the publishers, editors, or duly accredited reporters. Okay, from being compelled to reveal the source of any news report or information. Okay? Kahit hindi nila sabihin, okay, yung kanilang source. Okay? Extraterritorial application, basta involved ang Pilipino at ginawa sa Pilipinas, then the Data Privacy Act applies. Yun lang yung gustong sabihin nitong ano na to. Okay? Next, the NPC. Okay? Yun nga, RA 10173 creates the National Privacy Commission. And what is the function? Okay? Eto, 1, 2, 17. These are the functions of national of the NPC. Okay, why was it created? Okay, to administer and implement the provisions of the DPA, of this act. Okay, and to monitor and ensure compliance. Okay, and in ensuring the compliance of the country and in regulating sharing of information and in administering and implementing the provisions of RA 10173, ito yung kanyang mga functions. Okay, basahin na lang ninyo. Okay? Okay, the commission shall ensure at all times the confidentiality of any personal information that comes to its knowledge and possession. Okay? Organizational structure, okay, the commission shall be attached to the DICT and shall be headed by a privacy commissioner who shall also act as chairman of the commission. Okay? Kasi collegial body ang NPC. Okay, when we say collegial body, it has colleagues. Okay? The powers that are vested into the NPC might be the same. Okay? Or is the same actually with the powers given to other agencies na makakatrabaho ng NPC. Okay, kasi they are colleagues. Okay, collegial body ang ito. Itong Data Privacy Act na ito. Okay. Benefits, privileges, and emoluments equivalent to the rank of secretary. Yung chairman ng NPC, National Privacy Commission, okay, will have the same salary grade as a secretary of a government agency. Okay? Parang cabinet secretary, ganun. The privacy commissioner shall be assisted by two deputy privacy commissioners. Okay? Sila naman, ang kanilang equivalent would be undersecretary. Okay? Term and vacancy, the commissioner and the deputy commissioner shall be appointed for a term of 3 years. Okay? And reappointed, pwedeng i-reappoint for another term of 3 years. Okay? Vacancies in the commission shall be filled, okay, in the same manner in which the original appointment was made. Okay, qualifications, at least 35 years of age, good moral character, unquestionable integrity, known probity, and recognized expert in the field of information technology and data privacy. Okay. Next, deputy privacy commissioners must be recognized experts in the field of information and communications technology and data privacy. Okay. Okay. Ito. This is very important. The processing of personal information. Okay, there are three principles: proportionality, legitimate purpose, and transparency. So in sa principle of proportionality, ang kailangan nyo lang tandaan dito, you only collect information that you need. Okay? Dito, principle of legitimate purpose, dapat for a legitimate purpose, dapat hindi siya contrary to law, morals, public policy. Okay? And dapat in accordance with the law. Ayun na nga. Ayan, not contrary to law nga, di ba? Okay? And dapat, may specified purpose, and dun lang sa purpose na yun gagamitin. Okay? Yung makokollect ng information. And transparency. Okay? May transparency. Okay? Alam niya naman kung anong transparency. Okay? Personal information must be collected for legitimate purposes and specific dapat. Okay? Although legitimate din yung ibang purposes, it might not be specific. I mean, maraming purpose ang isang piece of information, and although legitimate silang lahat, at dapat maging specific. Okay, because the data subject must be informed kung ano ba ang saan ba gagamitin yung kanyang information. Okay? So although legitimate lahat yung mga yan, baka meron yung data subject, baka meron siyang mga ayaw, mga ganyan. Okay? So dapat specific purpose lang. Okay? Syempre, kung ano lang yung purpose, doon lang may authority yung PIC and PIP, okay, to process yung information. Okay? Okay, dapat ma-process din fairly and lawfully. And then, number three, accurate, relevant, and where necessary for purposes for which it is to be used. Okay, dapat, syempre, dapat correct din. Okay? Dapat accurate, dapat hindi fake news. Okay? Dapat ina-update. Okay? If, for example, they collected information about you, kinuha pangalan mo, okay, and then eventually you are married and nagpalit ka ng apelido, you have to update, okay, yung information na yun. For it to be accurate, okay, and of course up to date, okay. Inaccurate or incomplete data must be rectified, supplemented, or destroyed. Okay, or further processing restricted. And that's actually one of the rights of the data subject, which we will be discussing later. Okay, the right to correct. Okay, the personal information that's inaccurate. Okay, next, adequate and not excessive. Kasi nga meron tayong, di ba, principle of proportionality. Okay, and then retained only for as long as necessary. Okay, part of the data life cycle or the information life cycle is the destruction of information. Kasi if it's no longer needed, it must be destroyed. Okay? It must be retained only for as long as necessary. So yun nga, kung hindi na kailangan, destroy. Okay? And kept in a form which permits identification of data subjects for no longer than is necessary for the purposes for which the data were collected and processed. Okay, the PIC must ensure implementation of personal information processing principles set out herein. Okay, criteria for lawful processing. The processing shall only be permitted if the following conditions exist. Okay, in addition to not being contrary to law. Okay, or if it is permissible under law. Okay. Siyempre, unang-una yon, and then susunod tong anim. Okay? May consent, necessary sa isang transaction, maybe. Okay? Necessary for compliance, necessary to protect vital interest, necessary to respond to national emergency, necessary for the purposes of legitimate interests pursued by the personal, by the PIC or third party, okay, to whom data is disclosed. Okay? May data sharing kasi between the PIC and third persons. Okay? So, dapat the information that is processed, okay, for it to be lawful must be necessary for the purposes of legitimate interests, okay, pursued by the PIC. Okay? Next, sensitive personal information and privileged information. The processing of sensitive and privileged information shall be prohibited. Okay? Pag sinabing sensitive and privileged, we have already enumerated kung ano yung mga sensitive personal information. Apat yun, and then privileged information. Bawal yun. except in the following cases. If there is consent, if it is provided by existing laws and regulations, okay, necessary to protect the life and health of the data subject or another person, necessary to achieve the lawful and non-commercial activities of public organizations, necessary for purpose of medical treatment. Okay? So, kung for example, information about a certain patient is needed for the creation of a vaccine, o di kailangan, okay, kahit pa sensitive information yan, okay, kailangan i-disclose if it is for the purpose of creating a vaccine, for example. Okay? Next, the processing is necessary, the processing concerns such personal information as is necessary for the protection of lawful rights and interests. Okay? Subcontract, a PIC may subcontract the processing. Okay, pwede niyang, yun nga, pwede niya namang as mentioned kanina, pwede niyang pangalan nito na i-outsource, okay, sa isang PIP. Okay? Provided that the personal information controller, the PIC, shall be responsible for ensuring that proper safeguards are in place to ensure the confidentiality of the personal information process, prevents its unauthorized use, and comply with the requirements of this act, of the Data Privacy Act. Okay? Sige, rights of the data subject. Yung rights of the data subject, kung titingnan ninyo, medyo mahaba siya. Pero to summarize, okay, number one, this is the right to information. Kailangan ma-inform siya, the data subject. So, kailangan siyang ma-inform na gagamitin yung kanyang information. Okay, or ipaprocess yung kanyang personal information. Kailangan alam niya. Number two, right to object. Okay. Number three, right to access. Okay. Number four, right to correct. Gaya nga ng sabi natin kanina, if there is inaccurate information or outdated information, then the data subject has the right to correct those. Okay. Number five, this is the right to erase. Okay. Suspend, withdraw, or order the blocking, removal, or destruction. Sorry, destruction of his or her personal information, okay, from the PIC system upon discovery that the information is complete, outdated, false, okay. Pwedeng hindi niya i-update, pwedeng hindi niya i-correct, pwede niya ring i-erase, okay, ipa-erase, okay. Number six, right to damages, okay. Right to damages. So, be indemnified if it is used unlawfully or if yung kanyang information is inaccurate, incomplete, outdated, false. Okay? Unlawfully obtained or unauthorized use. Okay? Ginamit sa purposes other than the intended purpose. Ayun. Tapos, or na-obtain siya unlawfully. Okay? Yun. May right to damages. Yung data subject. Okay? Meron din tayong tinatawag na right to data portability. Ang kailangan nyo lang tandaan dito, parang napapadali siya. Okay? May structured and commonly used format. Okay? So, para maayos. Okay? And then, of course, number 8, na right would be right to file a complaint. Okay? So, anim to, the right to data portability, 7, and the right to file a complaint. Okay, where? Una, dun sa nag-process. Okay? Dun sa nag-process ng information. Kung hindi kaya ng sa ganong level, then you may proceed to the NPC. Okay? Security of personal information, okay? Siyempre, there must be, this is of utmost priority kay itong security of personal information. Dapat ang personal information dahil hawak ng ibang tao and yung taong yon the data that sorry the PIC marami siyang hawak, marami siyang naka-store na information of different entities or different persons. So dapat secure, dapat may security. Okay? The PIC must implement reasonable and appropriate organizational, physical, and technical measures. Okay? Intended for the protection of personal information against any accidental or unlawful destruction, alteration, and disclosure. Okay? As well as any other unlawful processing. Okay? Lalo na kapag yung pinaglagyan ng information is electronic. Okay, who must have access? Dapat restricted. May username, may password. And yung user ID na yon, may certain information lang siya na pwedeng ma-access. Okay, like for example, yung sa St. Louis, yung information systems na gamit ng St. Louis, merong systems for communications. Okay, yung mga letters na dumadaan, yung mga letters na sinusulat ninyo, it goes through different offices. Okay, merong a database for that. Okay, yung grades, andun din. May sariling database yan. The subjects you enrolled, which students are enrolled in this code, mga ganyan. Okay, all of this information dapat protected against unlawful destruction, alteration, and disclosure. Okay? As well as against any other unlawful processing. Okay, number two, okay, the PIC shall implement reasonable and appropriate measures to protect against natural dangers such as accidental loss or destruction. Okay, backup. Okay, if, di ba, nung nabaha tayo, because of Typhoon Ulysses, there might be some manual records that have been damaged, no? So, to prevent such damage, dapat yung PIC, the Personal Information Controller, must have measures, security measures para ma-prevent yung loss due to accident or fortuitous events. Okay? And also, human dangers such as unlawful access, fraudulent misuse, and alteration and contamination. Okay? For example, may access ka sa grades, no? And then you are not authorized to alter your grades. Pero kung nahanap mo yung user ID that can do such a thing, di pinalitan mo na yung grade mo from the very start, ginawa mong 99 lahat, o di ang ganda ng transcript mo, di ba? So, dapat the PIC must prevent, okay, must have a measure, a security measure that prevents such things to happen. From happening. Okay, number three, determination appropriate level of security. Okay, and then personal information, the PIC must further ensure that third parties processing personal information shall implement the security measures. Okay, and the employees who are involved shall operate and hold personal information against strict confidentiality. So, if you are an employee of a certain entity which processes information, syempre makikita mo yan. You will have to do that. You will have to look at it kasi nga, part of your job. Pero, if you take that information outside of your job and you use it ginamit mo siya for unlawful purposes or purposes na it might be lawful pero without the consent of the data subject, then okay, hindi pwede yon. Okay? Dapat may security against that. Okay, dapat parang you ensure, okay, the PIC must ensure that your personnel will act okay with strict confidentiality.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then if there are data breach, if there is a data breach, then the PIC shall promptly notify the NPC and the affected data subject. Okay? Accountability, each PIC is responsible for personal information under its control or custody, including information that has been transferred to a third party for processing. So, gaya na sabi natin kanina, there's data sharing between the PIC and third parties who request for such information. And actually, such data sharing must have an agreement, okay? Dapat may agreement, may parang terms and conditions or something. Okay, now, the PIC is responsible if it transfers information to a third party for processing. Okay? For example, transfer niya sa isang PIP, then responsible or accountable ang PIC, okay, doon sa transfer of information. Okay? The PIC is accountable for complying with the requirements of this act and shall use contractual or other reasonable means to provide a comparable level of protection. Yun nga yung sinabi natin kanina, the DSA, the Data Sharing Agreement between the PIC and the third party who requests for such information. Okay? Dapat nakalatag doon kung ano yung terms and conditions nila. Okay? The PIC shall also designate an individual or individuals who are accountable for the organization's compliance with this act. Okay, we call this the Data Privacy Officer, the DPO. Okay, so the PIC must designate, okay, a DPO. Okay, siya yung mag-ensure that the organization is compliant with the act, with the Data Privacy Act. Okay? Okay. Responsibility of heads of agencies. Okay, all sensitive personal information maintained by the government. Okay, for example, LTO. Syempre, sa LTO, magko-collect 'yan ng ano ng for people who wants to apply or for people who want to apply for driver's license. Syempre, they will provide certain information and after that, the LTO will accumulate this information. Ang daming tao, ang daming nag-request eh. So, ang dami nilang hawak na information. Okay? So, it's the duty of the head of that agency, okay, to secure, okay, yung information na hawak niya. Okay? With the use of the most appropriate standard recognized by the information and the communications technology industry. Okay, because the information and communications technology industry are the experts. Sila yung nakakaalam kung ano bang dapat i-apply na security measure. Okay, and whatever the recommendation of that industry would be, then as far as practicable, yun ang gagamitin ng mga heads of agencies. Okay? Yon. Okay? Requirements relating to access by agency personnel to sensitive personal information. Okay, on-site and online. No employee of the government shall have access to sensitive personal information on government property or through online facilities unless the employee has received a security clearance. Okay, parang sinasabi lang na you have no access or bawal kang mag-gain ng access if it is not authorized by the head of the agency. Okay. And then offsite. Okay, bawal galawin. Okay? Unless a request is approved. Okay? So, yun. Penalties, okay? Andito na, basahin nyo na lang. Okay? Wala naman nang i-explain dyan. Okay? The extent of liability for juridical persons, okay? The penalty shall be imposed upon the responsible officers. Okay? For example, a corporation, o, sino bang i-charge dyan? Eh, the board of directors. Okay? Kung partnership, could be the managing partner or if in the absence of a managing partner, all the partners. Okay? Mga ganyan, okay? Who participated in or by the gross negligence allowed the commission of the crime. Okay? Since this is a law, any violation sa law na ito is a crime. So if such crime is committed, then the persons charged with governance of these entities, corporations or partnership or any juridical person, cooperatives, ganyan, okay? Then, yun, may liability sila. Okay? And yun nga, i-impose siya dun sa mga persons charged with governance. Now, if the offender is a juridical person, the court may suspend or revoke any of its rights. Okay? If the offender is an alien, he or she shall be deported. Okay? Pwede siyang ipa-deport. Okay? Public official, pwede siyang matanggal sa trabaho. Okay? Subject to the rules of RA 6713, okay? This is the code of conduct of ano of government employees or civil servants. Okay? Public officials kasi to eh. Okay? Or yun nga, employees, civil servants. Okay? In a large scale data breach, okay? The maximum penalties shall be imposed. 'Di ba may mga ranges tayo dito? Okay, kapag large scale, automatic yung pinakamataas na nandyan. Yun ang ibibigay doon sa, ayan ang i-impose doon sa offender. Okay? An accessory penalty consisting in disqualification, okay. O, hindi lang criminal, may administrative pa. Okay? Restitution, okay. For any aggrieved party shall be governed by the provisions of the new civil code. Okay? Who are required to register PICs or PIPs who employ at least 250 employees. Okay? If you are also an entity that processes information of at least 1,000 individuals, okay? If data processing is likely to pose risk on the rights and freedoms of a freedom of data subjects, if it is not occasional, if it kapag service providers to the government, okay? Contractors, caterers, mga ganyan. Basta you provide service to the government, then you're required to register with the NPC. Okay? Ayan. Subject to the approval of NPC, may designate a data privacy protection officer. Data protection officer, yung DPO na sinabi ko kanina. Okay? Next. Okay, pwede rin magkaroon ng compliance officer for privacy. Okay? Okay, data privacy manual. Ito ang contents. Okay? Okay, oh, ito na yung information life cycle na sinasabi ko kanina. Starts with data collection and, or creation. Okay, data collection and creation. Okay, and then data storage and transmission. Then it's being used. And then data sharing between yun nga, PIC and a third party. Tapos retention, it goes back to the database, or it is destroyed if it's no longer needed. Okay, retained if needed, destroyed if not needed. So yan, paulit, it's a cycle. Okay, oh, yan na yun. Okay. So that's it for the Data Privacy Act. So stay tuned, we still have two lessons more, the IPL and e-commerce. Okay, thank you and good morning everyone. God bless and good luck sa exams ninyo today.